policies and procedures provide the confidence that every leader needs, and this benefits everyone. If a general shows confidence in his men, but always insists on his orders being obeyed, the gain will be mutual. At first glance, it may look as though Sun Tzu had a low opinion of soldiers, but this is not true. He believed in the importance of respect, and ensuring everyone understands their role is one sign of respect. Sun Tzu went on to talk about soldiers more compassionately when he said the following: "Regard your soldiers as your children, and they will follow you into the deepest valleys. Look upon them as your own beloved sons, and they will stand by you even unto death." I feel this is something that organizations get wrong all the time. They talk about how the customer is king, and the customer comes first. But this isn't true at all. Your people come first. Your people are king. Your people should be treated as your own beloved sons. To put it bluntly, you won't have happy customers for very long if your people are unhappy and feeling resentful of you or the leadership team. Why would someone be willing to go that extra mile or even that extra inch when they are not valued by the people who lead them? Some might say it's because that's what they're paid for, but this is a short-sighted view. Competitors will be happy to pay your teams too, so what's stopping them from leaving? Other opportunities will present themselves, so what's stopping them from taking these opportunities? There are always opportunities for people to leave a poorly run organization. There is an oft-quoted statement that people don't leave bad jobs, they leave bad bosses.